Here we have the user interface for the safety training kiosk. When no one is working on the kiosk, there will be screensavers which will keep coming. There will be a prompt of "Let's start" to begin. Once the home page comes, you can select your language, local language, Hindi, English, and you can select the user type. It could be employee, visitor, contractor, delivery man, safety man, driver, security. So you can select the user type. There will be two types of identifications. One will be finger scan, biometric. Once it has done that, then there will be face recognition. It will take 3 seconds to recognize your face. If your parameters are already stored, it will recognize your face. Otherwise, it will recognize your face, register your face, and then you have to fill in all the details. So you have to fill in mobile number, name, email ID, optional, address is optional, purpose is optional. You can submit all these details to proceed further. Now you come to the training modules. So any number of modules can be fed to the screen. You can select what module you want to go through. We can select one. It will ask you to put your headphone and then start. This will take you to the entire journey, whatever information you want to give to the user in his particular language. You can add voice to the slides, or you can add music. You can increase the size of the video. You can not go any further until you have seen the entire video. You can only go back. Now, when the video is over, you can opt to view it again, or you can take the test. Once we click on take test, the questions will keep prompting one by one. Right now, there is question number one, which has an answer in terms of yes or no. I pressed yes, the question automatically changes to number two. I can think and reply to this question, and I have replied no. Then it automatically turns to question three. I can go back and forth also until I have replied with my answers to all the questions. One by one, all the questions will keep popping up and I have to answer. I can take my own time. Once I have replied to all the questions, I can submit my answer sheet. So it will calculate and tell me how many answers I have done correctly. So this is my scorecard. 9 out of 10. So this is a passing mark. I can print my gate pass. If I had not done this, it will ask me to go back and take the test again. Now I will proceed to print my gate pass. So this is the format of a gate pass I will get. And I will get the options of print my gate pass, email my gate pass, or convert my gate pass into a PDF and send. Yeah, it has sent me the email and goes back to the home screen. Thank you.